divine souls. We'll continue where we left off yesterday by singing the second doha of the Bhakti Shatak, Joi Radha, Soi Krishna Hai. Jai Radhe Krishna, Radhe Radhe, Radhe Krishna, Radhe Jai. Radhe Radhe Krishna, Radhe Jai Radhe Krishna, Radhe Radhe, Radhe Krishna, Radhe Jai Radhe. Jai Radhe Krishna, Radhe Radhe, Radhe Krishna, Radhe. Radhe Radhe, Radhe Krishna, Radhe. Jai Radhe Krishna, Radhe Radhe, Radhe Krishna, Radhe. Jai Radhe Krishna, Radhe. Jai Radhe Krishna, Radhe Radhe, Radhe Krishna, Radhe. Jai Radhe, Jai Radhe. Radhe, Jai Radhe, Jai Radhe, Radhe. Krishna, Jai Krishna, Jai Krishna, Krishna. Krishna, Jai Krishna. Jai Krishna. Joi Radha Soi Krishna Hai. Naman Radhe Radhe Radha Soi Krishna Joi Radha Soi Krishna Hai In Me Bhed Naman Radhe Radhe Radha Soi Krishna Hai Inamidha Naman Radhe Radhe Ik hai ladini Shakti Aru Shakti Man jaan Radhe Radhe Ladini Shakti Aru Bhakti Man Ek Jaan Radhe Radhe Ek Hai Ladini Shakti Aru Shakti Man Ek Jaan Radhe Radhe Hai Ladini Shakti Aru Jaan Radhe Jai Radhe Krishna Radhe 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 Krishna 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 Radhe Yesterday, while explaining the very first doha of the Bhakti Shatak, you got a little glimpse of how in a very concise way Shri Kripaluji Maharaj is reconciling all the many varied theories related to God just with this one simple explanation. Ved says, Ekameva dvitiyam brahma nehana nasti kinchana. There's only one God. There can be nothing else. Chandogya Upanishad. So Shri Maharaji said, Advitiya ek tattva hai. However, there are unlimited divine powers and unlimited divine forms of God. So yesterday I explained that all of those forms are purna. They're all absolute, complete, eternal, divine. They're all just one single God manifesting in these various forms. So they're all called Bhagavan. But there is one supreme form who is called Swayam Bhagavan. So that is Shri Krishna. Shri Krishna is Swayam Bhagwan, or he's called Avatari. Avatari means the one who takes avatar, the one who appears in the form of all the other forms of Bhagwan that we have. However, this first doha also stated that it is Shri Radha herself who appears in the form of Shri Krishna. And he appears in the form of every other form of God. The second doha gives some more insight into this special divine science and the interrelationship between Radha and Krishna. There are two terms used, Shakti and Shaktiman. Shakti means the power, And Shaktiman means the base in which the power resides. The relationship between the Shakti and the Shaktiman is also considered to be bheda-bhed. Bhed meaning distinction, and abhed meaning no distinction. How can both be true at the same time? In fact, we see this not only in relation to divine powers, but even in this world. And there's an analogy given in the Brahmavaivart Puran. Yathak chire chadhavalyam. Milk is white. So milk has shvetima. It has whiteness. We use two different words to describe it, right? We say there's milk and there's whiteness. So there's bhed. But can you ever separate the whiteness from the milk? No. So there's abhed. In other words, it's one thing but being described according to its characteristics by two different names in two different ways. So this analogy is being given to help us understand the bheda-bhed sambandh between Radha and Krishna. Just like a fire and its power to burn. So the power to burn is the shakti, or the power to give light is the shakti. But where does that power reside? In the fire itself. But has anyone ever tried to separate out that shakti, the shakti to give light or the shakti to burn, and keep the fire over here and the shakti over there? It's ridiculous. It's impossible. Fire itself is that thing that has the power to burn and give light. So although we can describe it separately, you have fire and then you have the power of giving light which resides in the fire, fine, it's a way of explaining, but you can't actually separate the two. Similarly, Radharani is called Shakti and Shri Krishna is Shaktiman. So we call them by two names, but you can't, it's just for calling, it's just for naming, or it's just for describing. But just like milk and whiteness are not actually two different things, and fire and the power to burn are not actually two different things, Radha and Krishna are not actually two different personalities. They are one and the same. So here Sri Maharaji is saying, Joi Radha, soi Krishna hai. Whatever is Radha, the same as Sri Krishna. Ye yam Radha, yascha Krishna. Exact translation of a mantra from Radhiko Upanishad. Iname bheda naman. Don't consider them to be separate. Ved goes on to say, Ye yam radha yascha krishno rasabdhir dehe naikah kridan artham dvidhabhut. Although Radha and Krishna are not two, they're one and the same, but they appear in two forms for the sake of doing krida, which means to play, to do leelas. Chaitanya Mahaprabhuji says, Radha Krishna ek atma dui deha dhari. Radha and Krishna are one atma. Atma here not meaning a soul like us, but atma like paramatma. Radha Krishna are one atma who has taken two dui deha, two deha, two bodies. But one single atma means one single personality. Anyonya vilase rasa aswadana kari. Chaitanya Charitamrit goes on to say, then in one form Sri Radha is enjoying the ras of her own self in the form of Shri Krishna. And Shri Krishna is enjoying the ras of his own self in the form of Radha. And this happens through the leelas, which are only possible since Radha and Krishna exist in these two forms, even though they are only one. So Radharani is Shakti. Shakti and Shri Krishna is Shaktiman. Exactly what Shakti? Shri Maharaji says Ahladini Shakti. So what is Ahladini Shakti? Shri Krishna has unlimited divine powers, but the main power is called Swarupa Shakti. Krishnera Ananta Shakti Tate Tin Pradhan Chit Shakti Jeeva Shakti, Maya Shakti Naam, Antaranga, Tatastha, Bahiranga, Kahijare, Antaranga, Swarupa Shakti, Savar, Upare. Again from Chaitanya Charitamrit, out of all of God's powers, the main power, his most supreme power is called Swarupa Shakti. Swarupa Shakti is God's personal power. That personal power has three aspects. Sat Chit Ananda Krishnera Swarupa Ataeva Shri Krishna Hoy Tinarup Chit Shakti Hoy Tinarup. Shri Krishna himself has three main qualities. Sat Chit Anand, therefore his personal power also has these three facets to it. Swarup Shakti has a Sat aspect, Chit aspect, and Anand aspect. Anandanshe Hladini, Sadanshe Sandhini, Chidanshe Samvit Jare Gyana Karimani. This personal power of Shri Krishna, Swarup Shakti, this supreme power, has three aspects. The Sat aspect is called Sandhini Shakti. This is God's almighty power. It's also through this power that he has a form, and that his divine abode has a form. Through this Sandhini power, which is the manifestation of the Sat aspect of Swarup Shakti. The Chit aspect of Swarup Shakti manifests as something called Samvit Shakti, which is the power of divine knowledge. Through this, God is all-knowing. He knows everything. And the Ananda aspect of Swarup Shakti is called Ahladini Shakti. So that's what's being referenced here, Ahladini Shakti. Ahladini Shakti is the power of bliss. Ahlad means giving bliss, giving joy or happiness. So that power resides within Shri Krishna, and through that power he is ever blissful. Ladini Sandhini Samvitvayeka Sarvasansthitau Hladata pakari mishra tvaino gunavarjite. Vishnu Puran mentions these three aspects of God's personal power. Ahladini, Sandhini, Samvit, the power of bliss, the almighty power, and the power of knowledge. And out of those, the topmost one is Ahladini Shakti. It contains all the other powers within it. See, Veda also confirms this. Tasya shaktayas tvanekadha ahladini sandhini gyanecha kriyadya bahuvidha shaktayah tasvahladini variyasi. Radhikopanishad says that Supreme God has unlimited powers. Out of all of them, Taswa, out of all of them, Hladini Variyasi. Hladini Shakti is supreme. So this Hladini Shakti is Radha. That's a short way of saying it. So the supreme power, God's personal power, the supreme aspect of that is the power of bliss, which contains the power of knowledge and the power of almightiness. So the Hladini Shakti is supreme. However, Ved goes on to say, Paramantaranga Bhuta Radha. Paramantaranga. Antaranga means personal, secret, andarwali, baat. So Paramantaranga, Param means supreme. The innermost thing. Paramantaranga Bhuta. Bhut or Bhuta means a tattva. Tattva means a power, a thing, a substance. So the Paramantaranga Bhuta, the absolute supreme innermost highest thing is Radha. Paramantaranga Bhuta Radha. This is after saying Ahladini Shakti is supreme. So Ahladini Shakti, that's a short way of saying it. You want to go further into it? Chaitanya Charitamrita says, Ahladini Shakter Paramasar Taro Premanam. The essence of that Ahladini Shakti is called Prem. Prema Shakti, the divine love power. Premera Paramasar Mahabhava Jani Sei Mahabhava Rupa Radha Thakurani. So the essence of Ahladini Shakti is Prema Shakti. And the essence of Prema Shakti is Mahabhav. And the very form of Mahabhav is Radha. Nothing beyond that. That's it. So here Sri Maharaj is saying in short that this Ahladini Shakti, Radharani, resides within Shri Krishna, but this is a very concise way of saying it. In his Vyakhya, if you get this Bhakti Shatak Vyakhya that he's written, he explains that the essence of the power of bliss is divine love, and the essence of divine love is called Mahabhav, and that is indeed Radharani herself, none other. This is why Radharani is said to be Sansha Kamala Shailaputri Tam Radhikam Shakti Dhatrim Namamah. Shruti, Ved herself is saying, we bow down to that Radharani who is the Shakti Dhatrim. She is the source of all divine powers. It all emanates from her. She's the life force of the whole divine phenomenon. It is with her grace that God has formed. It is with her grace that all the divine powers are active. Sansha Kamala. Kamala is her ansha. Kamala, Lakshmi, is ansh of Radharani. Shailaputri, Durgaji, she's also ansh of Radharani. They are also called Shakti. But Radharani is Shakti Dhatrim. She is the giver of that Shakti. So she resides within Shri Krishna as his very soul. This is just a way of explaining it. These are all words. But they're there to help us understand that there is a science behind it. And when we become God-realized, we can understand it. But great saints have explained this to us so that we can have more faith in God and more faith in the system of our scriptures so that we can proceed on the path of bhakti and receive God's grace in this lifetime. So now you understand why, although Shri Krishna is Swayam Bhagwan, it is said that Yako Radha Tattva Pradhan. Radha Tattva is supreme and Yako Dujo Rupa Hai. Shri Krishna. She herself has become Shri Krishna. Mamaiva Paurusham Rupam Gopika Janamohanam. Brahma Vaivart Puran. Radharani is saying, I myself have taken the form of Shri Krishna. He is my male form. Or literally what she said is, my male form is the one who steals the gopis' hearts. So I myself have become Shri Krishna. Sanakadik Paramahans say, Radhikam Krishna Rupancha Krishno Radha Swarupaka Sanat Sanghita. In other words, Radha herself has become Shri Krishna. Shri Krishna himself is Radha. There's no difference between the two. Yet, from one way of looking at it, from one perspective, Radha is Shakti and Shri Krishna is Shaktiman. But as in the case of every Shakti and Shaktiman, there is a bhed meaning distinction, and there is abhed, non-difference between the two. So they are in fact absolutely one, but when we explain about them, we separate them out, saying Radha is gauri, Shri Krishna is dark complexion, Radha is very innocent and calm and simple, and Shri Krishna is very naughty, chanchal. We say that when Radharani does maan, Shri Krishna falls at her feet and washes her lotus feet with his tears. This is all for the sake of leelas. They do these leelas to themselves enjoy their own blissfulness and to give that blissfulness to the saints. But the most important thing to remember is that Radha and Krishna are one and the same. So you see, in the very first two dohas, Sri Maharaji has taken the whole divine philosophy of God. Who is God? What is God? What is the interrelation between all the different forms? And he's reconciled the whole thing into a very understandable philosophy. In the next doha, he goes further into the philosophy, explaining that there are actually three tattva. There is God, which we were just learning about, Brahm. There are souls, Jeev. And there is the material power, Maya. Jai Radhe Krishna Radhe 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 Krishna Radhe. 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 Jai Radhe. Jai Radhe. Radhe, Jai Radhe, Jai Radhe. Krishna Jaya Krishna Jaya Krishna 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 Jaya Krishna Jaya Krishna Krishna Shaktiman ki shaktiyan agnit yadapi bakhan radhe radhe shaktiman ki Shaktiyan Agnit Yadapi Bakhan Shaktiman Ki Shaktiyan Agnit yadapi bakhan radhe radhe Shaktiman ki shaktiyan Agnit yadapi Tina Mahamaya Jiva Aru Paratri Shakti Pradhan Radhe Radhe Mahamaya Jeevaru Trishakti Pradhan Tina Mahamaya Jeevaru Paratri Shakti Pradhan Radhe Radhe Mahamaya Jeevaru Paratri Shakti Pradhan Jai Radhe Krishna Radhe 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 Krishna Radhe 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 J Jai Radhe Krishna Radhe 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 Krishna Radhe. Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma. Ved tells us that everything about God is unlimited. Anant. So his powers are also anant. He has unlimited powers. But out of all of those, Krishnera Ananta Shakti Tate Tin Pradhan Chit Shakti Maya Shakti Jeeva Shakti Nam. Chit Shakti, another name for that is Para Shakti. Another name for that is Swarup Shakti, what I was just referring to a little bit earlier. This is God's personal power. Maya is the second power, and Jeev, the souls, are the third power. The same three powers are referred to in the Vishnu Puran. So out of all of God's powers, these three are prime. They're also called antaranga, bahiranga, tatastha. God's personal internal power, that's the swarup shakti. His external power, that's maya shakti. And the neutral or marginal power, that's jeev shakti, the souls. I mentioned yesterday that some of the Jagadgurus and great saints, they emphasized more on the oneness, especially Shankaracharya. And some emphasized on the fact that there's more than one tattva. And I told you that Jagadguru Shri Kripaluji Maharaj explained that, in fact, both perspectives are correct. God is synonymous with his swarup shakti, his personal power. So that's one tattva, God. Souls, all of us, unlimited souls that exist. We are jiva shakti, his soul power. And maya is the material energy, the matter that the whole universe is made out of. These are the three tattva. And there, these three tattva are referred to in the Vedas. Charam pradhanam amritaksharam harakshratmana vishate deva ekah tasya bhidhyanat yojanat tattva bhavad bhuyaschante vishvamaya nivrittih. Shvetashvatra Upanishad says that maya and jeev are two existences and they are ruled over by the supreme power, God. Ishate deva eka. There's one supreme dev and he does ish. He's the supreme governor of the other two, maya and the souls. So the Ved refers distinctly to these three different tattva. Then why did some of the Jagadgurus say that, no, there's only one thing? Even I quoted a mantra from Chandogya Upanishad earlier, ekameva dvitiyam brahma neha na nasti kinchan. There's nothing other than Brahma. Final. Kinchan. Couldn't be. Don't even imagine there could be anything other than Brahma. There's only God, nothing else. So there's one tattva. Then Ved turns around and says there's three tattva. In addition to God, there are souls and maya. So why is Ved saying that there's only one tattva? It's actually fairly simple to understand. God is not only the supreme controller of maya and the giver of life to the souls, he pervades us. Think of it this way. The wave is pervaded by the ocean, is it not? God is like the ocean, and all of the souls are like individual waves moving around on the ocean. So those waves emerge from the ocean and merge back into the ocean. They have a separate identity from the ocean, yet they are pervaded by the ocean itself. So we refer to the two separately. You have the wave and you have the ocean, because is the ocean limited by the wave? No. The wave is just on the surface of the ocean. It's a very small thing, a very insignificant thing in comparison to the entire ocean. The ocean is much more than just the wave. The ocean goes down for miles. So we refer to the two separately, and yet the wave is not separate from the ocean. Similarly, souls are not separate from God. He pervades us, just like the wave is pervaded by the water itself. So from that point of view, there's no difference between the wave and the ocean. There's no difference between souls and God. Regarding the material world, God pervades every particle of the material world as well. So it's like the dirt and the pot. What is the pot made of? It's made of soil, it's made of clay, earth. Once the pot has been made, you don't think of it as being made of clay or dirt or earth. You just see the pot. It's painted, there's some design on it. You call it a pot. Do you call it dirt? At that point, no. But it came from dirt and it will go back into dirt one day. So that's like this world is like that pot, and God is like the soil that the pot was made of. You don't see God in this world because we don't have divine eyes, but he's there. He pervades every particle of this whole universe. So just like the pot itself is pervaded by the earth, is made of the earth, this whole world is literally made of God. So there's no, from that point of view, there's no difference between God and Maya. Maya meaning the actual energy that all of this matter is made of. So from that perspective, God himself is Maya, God himself is the souls. So we say there's only one tattva, there's only Brahm and nothing else. That's fine, that's correct. But practically speaking, just like if someone were to ask you for a container and you brought them a pile of dirt, they would say, what are you doing? I need something that can hold some water. He says, a clay pot is made out of dirt. It's basically the same thing. Here, take this pile of dirt. They don't have the same function practically. So from one perspective, the pot and the dirt are one and the same. From another perspective, you can't practically live like that. So practically speaking, in fact, God is distinct from the souls, and he's distinct from Maya. Maya is jad. It's a lifeless power, mindless power. It doesn't have any of God's divine characteristics. It can't decide to create the universe on its own. It doesn't do anything on its own. It's only due to God's presence within Maya that Maya can take the form of the universe or manifest itself into the form of the universe. But Maya is a distinct entity, separate from God. That's why it, separate meaning not physically separate, but its characteristics make it separate from God. Similarly, we souls are not physically separate from God, and yet our characteristics make us distinct from him. We have limited knowledge, limited power, limited happiness, limited everything. We are not omnipresent, all-knowing, all-powerful. So our characteristics are very different from God's characteristics. Other than this fact that God is Chetan and we are Chetan. He's alive and we're alive. Other than that, we're very different from God. He is unlimited in every way and we are limited in every way. So from the perspective of our characteristics, we are very different from God. And yet, from the perspective of looking that God pervades us, you could say, no, there's no difference between souls and God. So depending what perspective a particular Jagadguru took, his bhashya or his explanation may appear radically different from the explanation of another Jagadguru or another saint. Same thing with various mantras of the Vedas, various shlokas from various scriptures. They may appear diametrically opposed, and yet all of their statements would be factual, correct, and true, because they're merely explaining a divine thing in a very concise way. So people can misinterpret that, they can misunderstand. But luckily for us, Jagadguru Shri Kripaluji Maharaj, he reconciled the whole thing, explaining how all of these statements by all of these saints and scriptures are in fact correct. So there's no reason for any kind of debate or argument. We can simply understand the whole picture, then we can just take that knowledge and use it to perform devotion. So we'll sing now the next doha, which tells us more about the characteristics of the soul. Jai Radhe Krishna, Radhe, Radhe, Radhe Krishna, Radhe. Jai Radhe Krishna, Radhe, Radhe, Radhe Krishna, Radhe. Jai Radhe Krishna, Radhe, Radhe, Radhe Krishna, Radhe. Radhe Radhe Krishna Radhe, Jai Radhe Krishna Radhe, Radhe Radhe Krishna Radhe. Jai Radhe Krishna Radhe, Radhe Radhe Krishna Radhe. Jai Radhe, Jai Radhe, Radhe, Jai Radhe. Radhe, Jai Radhe. Jai Radhe, 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 Krishna, Jai Krishna, Jai Krishna, Krishna. Krishna, Jai Krishna, Jai Krishna, Krishna. Jiva tatastha shakti par maya kar adhikar radhe radhe jiva tatastha shakti par maya kar adhikar radhe radhe jiva tatastha shakti par maya kar adhikar radhe radhe shakti par vastutastu yah das hai swami nand kumar radhe radhe vastutastu yah das kumar vastutastu yah das Swami Nand Kumar Radhe Radhe Astu Yah Das Jai Radhe Krishna Radhe 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 Krishna Radhe 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 Now in the fourth doha, Shri Maharaji tells us, in the fourth and fifth dohas, we learn about the entire situation of the soul. In fact, in these first five dohas, Shri Maharaji has put the entire philosophy in gist. The rest of this Bhakti Shatak is simply expounding upon what's already been explained in these first five dohas. This is why I'm taking more time on each of these first five. We'll move more quickly after this. So regarding the soul, we have so many questions. Who are we? What are we? Where did we come from? Why are we born in this world? Why does Maya lord over us. Here, who we are is described first. Jiva tatastha shakti. As we learned, there are three main powers of God. His personal power, which is called antaranga, meaning internal. Then there's maya, the material energy, that's called bahiranga. And then there, bahiranga meaning external. And the souls are neither considered to be internal or external. Not external because we don't have the same characteristics as maya. We're not jada. Jada meaning lifeless, mindless. So we're not. That's how maya is. We're not like that. We have life. We have a mind. We're sentient beings. So we can't be called bahiranga, yet we can't be called an antaranga shakti either. Because if we were part of God's antaranga shakti, we would be his swanch. I explained yesterday that swanch means all the avatar of God, all the avatar of Shri Krishna, Vishnu, Shiva, Durga, all these forms of God, they are Shri Krishna himself. They're equal in power, equal in knowledge. They're all one and the same internally. But because he's only manifesting a fraction of his total personality, we call those other forms of God his Ansh. Ansh meaning a part of. But these are Swa-Ansh, Swa-Ansh. Souls cannot be said to be a part of his personal power. We're not a part of his antaranga shakti, swarup shakti, that ahladini, sandini, samvit. We're not a part of that. If we were, we would be God. There would be no difference between us and Shri Krishna from any perspective. We would be all-knowing, omnipresent, just like him. So we are not a part of his personal power, antaranga shakti. We're not a part of his maya shakti. So we can't be said to be external. We can't be said to be internal. So we're tatast. Tata, like the bank of a river, kinara. You're not in the river. You're not in the jungle. You're on the beach in between. That's the tata, the bank of the river. So compared to, if you think of God as the river and maya as the jungle, we're neither in the jungle nor in the river, we're on the bank. So we're tatastha. Stha meaning sthit. That's where we exist. That's where we are, on the tat. So all of the souls, and there are infinite number of souls, all of them taken together are Shri Krishna's jiva shakti. And that jiva shakti is on the tat. It is neither a part of his swarup shakti, nor is it a part of maya shakti. So it is not called internal, nor is it called external. It's called tatast, in between the two. So what are we? What is our identity? We are ansh of Shri Krishna's jiva shakti. So one of the characteristics of all souls, we have this tatast lakshana. We're a part of, we're ansh of this jiva shakti, which is in between. So you want a technical answer as to who are we? That's the technical answer. We're ansh of Shri Krishna's jiva shakti, which is in between. It's neither part of his internal shakti nor his external shakti. That's the technical description. So here, Sri Maharaji says, jiva shakti tatastha shakti par, but maya kar adhikar. Somehow maya is able to have adhikar over us. It means maya rules over us, has us under its bondage. And yet, vastu tastu, in reality, the soul is Das, Swami Nanda Kumar. The soul is a natural servant, and Shri Krishna is our Swami. He is our master. Dasa bhutamidam tasya jagat sthavar jangamam Shri Mannarayana Swami Jagatam Prabhurishwara. Padma Puran says all the souls, whether they're currently born in a form that allows them to move around like human or animal or insect, or they're born in a form that doesn't allow them to move like a plant or a tree, all the living beings are das, and God is our Swami. And this relationship I also explained to you yesterday, not in these words, but I told you that every ansh is drawn to his anshi. Actually, that may not have been in this satsang yesterday. That was probably in the morning satsang I had. So we are ansh of Shri Krishna. He is our anshi, meaning he's like the ocean and we're a drop of water in the ocean. So every ansh is drawn to his anshi. If a drop of water rains down anywhere on land, it never stops moving until it reaches the ocean. So it's drawn towards the ocean. That attraction between the ansh and the anshi is natural. In the same way, we being ansh of Shri Krishna, that's a short way of saying it, we're ansh of one of his powers, his jeev shakti. We being his ansh, we're naturally attracted to him. We naturally love him. And the nature of love is to serve. So this is why another way of stating the identity of the soul is to say we are the servant of Shri Krishna and he is our master. So see, I gave you two ways of answering the question, who am I? You know you're a soul, but what is the soul? Soul is ansh of Shri Krishna's tatastha shakti, the soul power. Or you can say, soul is a servant of Shri Krishna. Jivera swarupahoya krishnera nitya das. Simply stated by Shri Kripa, by Chaitanya Mahaprabhuji. Just says, what is the identity of the soul? Your identity is you are the eternal servant of Shri Krishna. That is what you as a soul desire, to serve him. And you will never be satisfied until you get to realize that relationship in person with him. But right now we have a problem. Maya kar adhikar. Right now Maya is separating us from Shri Krishna. We're unable to experience him because we are under the bondage of Maya. So why is Maya able to do this? Shri Maharaji answers in the next doha, but we'll save that for tomorrow. Bolie Vrindavan Bihari Lal Ki Jai.